party was too much. I was so exhausted, you know.
You were exhausted? What did you do? You didn't even dance. I was the one dancing, my dear. I danced and I danced and I danced until I could dance no more. I quietly slipped out of the party and there was this Chastis guy outside. He was all over me. In fact, he even gave me his card.
Tell
guess
me
where
some.
He works. He works in Shell Port Harcourt. You know, he
oh
now...
Oh my God.
What?
Look over at that table.
Which table?
Oh my God. He is cute.
Cute? Jesus. Look at him. The guy is hotter than fire. I think there's something about this guy I can't really place my finger on.
But of course, of course. I once had. And I still have a huge crush on him.
Really?
Well, it's over 2 years with the jam in the same center. Girlfriend. That guy isn't only cute. His brain is also on fire.
What?
He left a record behind in his former school that everybody believes will never be broken in 100 years. Straight A's. He had straight A's in all of his subjects. Math, English, everything.
2 minutes.
When our jam results came out, he scored the highest mark ever in the history of jam.
What?
But it was rumored that his result was withheld because it was impossible for just one guy to be that smart. He even had to face a panel of teachers and questions just to prove his intelligence. Fact.
I wonder why God can be so unfair. I mean, how can God be so generous to one guy by giving him everything? Everything plus extra.
So what are you going to do about it?
Nothing. I mean, I can't possibly question God.
Oh.
So, what are you going to do about him? You said you once had a crush on him, don't you?
Well,
then
yeah.
Do something.
Hey, stop. Sorry I was late, bro. What's up?
Actually, I just walked in right now.
Mel boy, I want pizza, man.
Hey, ask those guys now.
You now have him on a platter of gold. It is now or never, girl.
For what?
Go meet him.
No, I can't. What would I possibly say to him?
Don't be silly, girl. Anything like when you first met him.
Okay, but I can't go. Would you please go with me?
All right.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi.
You don't recognize me?
Have we met before?
Yeah. We wrote jam together in the same center 2 years ago. I was actually sitting like 2 seats behind you.
Oh yes, now I remember. I was actually thinking and I was looking over there. I said, wow, you're so cute. Actually, I wanted to come over there and talk with you, but my God failed me. So, have a seat.
So, how was everything?
Help me! Help me! Help me! Everyone, help me!
Stanley, what is that?
It's a bag.
I know, but where are you going with it?
I'm off to school, Mom. I want to be staying in a hostel.
Why don't you like going to school from home anymore?
I think I will enjoy it better in school with my friends. You see, Mom, I really want to face the reality of this life.
That is what we want for you, son. But you know you are epileptic. If you are with us here, we can watch over you. But if you're out there without us, you can run a risk of a fatal injury or struck by a fit. I know it can happen anywhere, even when you are crossing the road.
Exactly. That is the point, Mom. It can happen anywhere. It can happen any place. On the road. It's good. Where nobody will be with me. For instance, it happened to me today in a restaurant.
Oh my God.
It happens to me every day. When I'm never at home. I never bothered to tell you. Staying at home is not the solution. You cannot completely protect me from this illness, Mom. I have to. Staying at home depresses me. It reduces my sense of belonging as a man. Staying at home takes away independence of a man from me. Mom, please. I want to go out there and face the reality of life. I want to live like a man. I want to go out there and mix up with my friends. Yes. I know I am epileptic, but it's not my fault. I just have to go out and mix with understand. Please.
Mom, please let him be.
But the young man is right. Let him find his happiness. Do you have any money on you?
I have enough to live for a while.
Please, son, when you go, try to come and see us often. Please. God will protect and guide you.
Okay. I will always remember to come home.
You can just feel comfortable.
Yeah.
You know, we'll be managing out you.
Yeah, thank you very much. Oche, I want to thank you. I really want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being such a good friend.
What have I done?
A lot. You see, I like to make friends. I really do. But I never had any. All my friends dumped me the moment they discovered that I'm epileptic. But you are very different.
But
that is the greatest sacrifice anyone has ever done to me.
You know, your condition doesn't make you any less a human being. You know, you are a special person. Yes, and you're nice. And what matters is being nice from the inside. And that's what you are, you know?
Yes. It's been the dark side of me. I mean, my personal hell
I try as much as possible to forget about it. But it always comes back to haunt me.
But I'm wondering, how come you never told me about this thing?
I lose friends when I do.
Does Annie know about it?
No. In all my relationship, I've always learned to live one day at a time. I try as much as possible not to let any girl that I'm going out with to know that I'm epileptic. The moment I open up to any girl in all my relationship that I'm epileptic, they will run away from me faster than a jet.
You know what? You can't hide the truth for too long. One way or the other, she will know. So I think you should tell her. You know, you should.
In all my relationship, I try to live one day at a time. So I try to extend the little happiness I have with Annie for now. Because I've lived with this hermit all my life, and I know the stigma that comes with it.
Stigma? What do you mean stigma? Do you mean everybody that knows you or you have a condition would run away from you? But look at me, I haven't run away.
You are the only exception.
That's what I'm saying. Because I didn't run away when I knew your condition means that there are people out there who won't run. And Annie, for one, who loves you very much, will definitely not run away. You see? So I think you have to tell her.
No, I will not.
If you won't tell her, I will, though.
No, you will not do a thing like that. Listen, this is my personal problem. My personal affair.
All right.
I just beg of you to let me handle it.
Okay. I'll try this. Yeah, come in.
Hello, City!
Hello. What's up? Don't you look good today?
Yeah.
Come here, you're sitting on the floor.
What? What is wrong?
No, nothing.
Okay, I'm not a soothsayer, but you guys look down.
Who wouldn't be down after carrying a very big bag that I carried?
What bag?
I just moved in.
Oh my God, it's a lie. So why did you finally change your mind?
Oh, I am sick of staying at home.
You are just moving in. He's just coming here to read, not for us. So.
I've decided to prepare something really special to celebrate your arrival. What would you like?
Oh, that's good.
What would you like?
You know what? That kitchen here, you got lots of food stuff. So you could just boil us some beans.
Please, what
beans and bread.
Oh,
no, I want something special.
But please, you are not farting, bros. Because I heard you fart a lot.
Oh, my God.
Sorry.
I cannot even believe I kissed that mouth. Did you see those things? Just foamy, slimy saliva gushing out of his mouth. God help me. Worst of all, not even in front of that bitch, Sharon. Christ, I'm so embarrassed.
Good. Epilepsy. This is my first time to see an epileptic victim. And it turned out to be Stanley. Our very own Stanley.
Not anymore.
What do you mean?
Joanne. He may be your own very Stanley. But from the moment I saw that thing, he stopped being my Stanley, okay?
Honey! Annie, just take it easy. I mean, you love this guy like you love yourself. Don't take such a brash decision.
I love him. Any girl will fall for him. I mean, the guy is cute, handsome, intelligent, but he's epileptic. And worst of all, he's a liar. And that I cannot live with.
Liar? How?
How? Stanley knew all this while that he had epilepsy. He never even told me, Joanne. No wonder he was even pestering me about marrying him. He wanted me to get to know about his condition so late. I'm returning the engagement ring to him. I'm no longer interested.
Honey! If he had told you he was epileptic from the beginning, would you have still gone out with him? No, answer me. I know the answer is no. And you just can't blame this guy. Maybe what he was counting on is to get you fall so deeply in love with him first. So that when he eventually tells you, your love for him will not make you leave him.
He didn't even think about my health. I heard that thing is contagious. He was practically... He wanted to infect me with it, Joanne. He wanted to infect me so that I won't be able to leave him. He wanted me to be stuck to him. That's wickedness.
Good. Is it contagious?
Of course it is. Or so I heard. They say if the saliva touches you or any part of your body, the person begins to act like them, you know?
Don't tell me. Are you serious?
Of course I am. Dead serious.
Oh my God. Oche had it all over his two hands when he was pushing the pen into Stanley's mouth.
He did?
Yes.
Oh my God. Then I'm so happy to announce to you that your dear boyfriend is already infected as we speak.
That's a lie. Then Stanley indeed is a very wicked human being. I mean, he's hanging out with people when he knows he could infect them. Damn. Good. Oche and I will have to take a break. Yes.
Why? Whatever for?
Until I am sure he is not infected and that he is no more living with Stanley. Yes.
My God, how amiable. I thought you loved Oche so much.
Oh yes, I do love him. I'm not blending with my heart.
And you are trying to make me feel like a terrible person.
Your guy now. Chief, what's up now? What are you trying to tell him? You don't have anything to do with him.
Okay, I'll call you.
Alright.
Hello, girls, what's up?
Hi.
Cynthia, did you see
Chewa
for me?
No. You're not serious. You know what, Conti? You don't have anything to do with Emeka. You're not serious.
Hey,
you.
Boyfriend, of course.
What happened to him?
Stanley is epileptic.
What?
That's how we saw it, though. You need to see how this guy is slumped, shaking with spit gushing out of his mouth.
God,
I had never been that scared in my whole life. You need to see the way he was rolling on the floor.
Wow. What is epilepsy?
Epilepsy. It happens when one has a fracture in the brain. My mommy told me it comes all of a sudden. And it is hereditary. He could have inherited it from his family, who knows? And it happens anywhere, anytime. Girls, I even heard you can contract epilepsy if the person's saliva touches your own body.
What?
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. That was what I heard. Oh, I should bring to you.
Alright, girls. See you.
I'd like to see her.
Is there any problem?
Would you stop questioning me? Come on, go in and get Joanne for me. Madam, can I have my books?
Oh, your books, right?
No, my head. Come on, go in and get my books for me.
Maybe I'm still using them.
So? I said go in and get my books. Before your boyfriend's friend infects my books with epilepsy.
Don't you have nylon? My friend, go and look for nylon bag and put this thing.
Crazy.
She said get a nylon.
Out now, and she doesn't want to see me again. That is the story of my life.
Man, why do you talk like this? You're underrating the strength of this girl's love for you, man.
I don't share in your optimism. Annie cannot stand not to see me for a whole day. Not to talk of 3 days. She'd not seen me for 3 whole days.
But John also hasn't seen me for 3 days. It doesn't mean I've broken up with her or she's broken up with me. Huh? Don't talk like this, man. Okay? Don't just jump into conclusions. Alright?
Okay. But you know, Jack, if she dumps me, I swear to God, something might happen to me because I know I love her so much.
Don't worry. She's not gonna dump you. Alright?
This person.
Go around town telling people he's an epileptic person.
Of course not. We are not everyone. We are his friends, and Annie is his girlfriend. If he doesn't tell us, then he should tell Annie.
Listen, he can't go around telling everybody, can he? Okay.
Well, IA epilepsy is contagious.
Now that is a crazy thing to say. It is not, and that's not true.
I was told by a reliable source that it is, and I suggest you send him packing out of your room.
What are you saying? Are you crazy?
No, I am dead serious here.
I can't possibly ask him to get out. He's your friend, he's my best friend, he's our friend. I can't throw him out of the house like that.
Hey, look here. It is either he goes or I go. You had better choose one now.
John, I don't think I know you anymore. Yeah. You've changed. Are you just changing?
Spare me.
Spare you?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna do that. Not. Please go ahead, let her talk to him now.
Hi.
Hello. How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
I've been waiting, you know. So, why are you drawing away from me? It's me and it's me, Stanley, remember?
Stanley,
I thought I knew you. I thought I knew everything about you. To think that you were epileptic and you couldn't even tell me. What were you thinking? What? You...
I'm sorry.
Obviously, there are so many other things you're hiding that you haven't told me. But you know what? I don't care.
What are you saying?
Listen, wait and stand there. And it's over.
Oh, come on, Annie, please. Don't put an end to this, okay? Don't put an end to the magic we shared together. Remember, I love you so much. You meant the world to me. I know I'm epileptic, but it's not my fault. I was trying to tell you, but I was just afraid of losing you.
I love you too. I love you so much. There is no true love without trust. You should have told me. You should have told me. I have the right to know. I love you. I love you so much, but I can't. I'm so sorry. I can't.
Annie?
Man, you don't need this. You don't need this, man. Come on, let's go. I don't believe you need this. Let's go, man. Let's go. Let's go.
Man, what's up?
I'm cool. How is lecture, man?
Fine. Man, the news is all over the campus.
Epileptic. It's hard to believe. Such an intelligent guy.
Hey, you. I saw it myself.
And we have been living in the same room with him all the while.
What? You are talking like he's not human?
I am talking because they said it's contagious.
Contagious? That's a big lie.
Go ahead. Laugh all you want. I am moving out of this room by weekend.
Are you serious?
Of course, yes. Who wanna take chances?
Hey guys!
Hi, you're welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, hi guys.
Hey, what's up?
Oh, that's us.
What's up, man?
What's up with those guys, man? It's like they are running away from us.
You haven't seen anything. Everybody on campus is politely avoiding me now. In a class. In a cafeteria. Even in the library. Look at Sylvester. Sylvester and Bishop don't even want to stand with me.
Man, that is bad, though. That's really bad.
All of that I can take. But not a funny, I cannot stand. I love Annie so much. She meant the whole world to me. She's everything to me. Without her, there is no reason for me to leave.
Hey, what are you saying, man? What are you saying? Please, I beg. Don't even tell me that. Don't give that mad shit, man. There are more than a million reasons why you should be alive. Look at your parents, for instance. Those people love you. They care for you. You should be alive for them. For some angry girl who is angry. I beg, don't give me that.
Well, it's quite unfortunate that we'll not have a grandchild. Because no woman wants to get down with me.
Do you know I hate it when you do this self-pity thing? I really hate it. Can you just cut it, okay? You're going to have a fine woman for a wife. You're intelligent and smart. You can do it, man. Please, bros, I beg. Not even do you talk that kind of thing, please. You're okay, man. You're okay. Please. All right?
Uche, you've been a very good friend.
What are friends for?
I don't know how to thank you. It's well as well.
Thank you.
I'll meet you guys upstairs.
Tell Stanley and your boyfriend for chair. I can no longer stay in the same room because I don't have infected epilepsy. It's a matter of fact. Watching an apartment downtown is depressing.
You're also living there.
Yes.
Let me offer you something.
No, thank you.
I insist. Just malt or something.
Okay, I'll take malt.
Please give me malt. It's been quite a long time. I terribly missed you. Did you miss me?
I did.
Annie, I want you to know that epilepsy is not as terrible as a society makes it to be. People live their normal life with it, and it's not contagious.
How did you get it?
The doctor. The doctor said it was a pressure on my head during my mother's prolonged labor. So it could be a trauma or injury in the brain. It could happen to anybody, no matter your age.
You said it's not contagious?
No.
Not even the victim's saliva?
No. You see, anything that has to be contacted must come in a living form, just like a virus or a bacteria, something that could be seen under the microscope. And epilepsy doesn't have anything like that. Rather, the brain undergoes spasms, just like electric shock. So it's a fault in the brain rather than a living disease.
So sorry you have it.
Thank you.
Could it be passed from a parent to their children?
It has not been confirmed. But children, it could occur to children that doesn't have it from their lineage.
Is there a cure for it?
I'm sorry, there is none. But there's a drug for it to subside the attack. I have a can of it. If I take the drug, I could go on for like 6 months without attack. Honey, I want to show you something.
Please, please just put that away.
Come on, honey. You have to take this from me. Okay? There is no any woman in this world that could take this gift from me, except you. You remain the very best of my life.
Mister, I can't. I love you very much, Stan. I love you so much. I can't take it. I hate to see you helplessly on the floor fighting for your life, Stan. I can't bear to take it a second time. I can't. Even as we're seated here, I'm scared that you might fall again. I love you too much to be able to bear it, Stan. I can't.
I'm sorry.
Listen to me. You mean the whole world to me. My life is incomplete without you. Ever since you gave me this ring, I've been watching it. I gave you this ring with all my heart. And I can never find anybody that will take this ring from me except you.
Can't take it back. I love you. I love you so much.
You're living up. Pain.
Contagious as we think it is. It is hereditary, you know. And besides, the other way it could be contacted is unless every person has problems with the brain.
JT, I know you're a medical student, right?
Yeah.
You've not gone into deep research, but I was told by Lebsol that this thing is contagious. It is.
Joanne, all they need right now is our love and care. So let's stop discriminating.
I'm not convinced at all. I'm not.
At least give it a try.
All right. Just give me time, all right? Just give me time so that
I can.
Stanley, my son! Just look at you!
Hey!
You are now a complete man!
Thank God!
I thought the side that NYSC is all suffering. Eh?
Oh, come on, Mama. Whoever told you that obviously never served. Yes!
They have fattened you properly. God, I thank you. I thank you, Father.
Oh, my son.
I hope you did well there. Of course, Papa, I did very well. In fact, I won the Best Youth Copper Award.
We are proud of you. Ah, we know you will never let us down. How many of you took that position in your camp?
Just two of us. Myself and one other person from University of Jazz.
Really?
How is your friend, Uche?
Oh, Chair is serving in Abia. He will soon be true.
Yeah. Let's go in, my dear.
Mommy, you're still looking good.
Hey.
Huh? That's my son.
Thank you very much.
Alright,
have a nice day.
Okay,
have a nice day.
Alright, guys.
You.
Thank you, ma'am.
Where did you find him?
We met at a job interview.
God will specially bless you. Thank you, my son.
And you too, mother.
Jack is the most stubborn boy I have ever seen. He has a serious case of epilepsy. The sort is the type that doesn't like large gathering or crowd, and yet he's always insisting on going out.
Why?
He said he wants to find himself a job. Instead of working in his father's company, where he would take over as soon as the father retires.
So you mean there is really a job for him to do?
Yes, my son.
That is odd.
He said he's tired of working under the father's influence and shadow. That everywhere he goes to, people treat him specially because he's the son of Chief Maxwell. He wants people to recognize him as Jack, as himself.
Mom, please. Enough about me. I need some quiet to rest.
Exactly. That's exactly what he needs right now. A quiet moment. Please.
Okay. Thank you. You are Mr.
Stanley. Stanley Johnson.
Stanley, God bless you, my son.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
We hope to be seeing you more in this family.
Oh, I would like to come again.
I'm very sure that Jack will always like to see you again when he's fine.
Yes.
Oh, and I'm sure he will want to make friends with you.
Me too.
What about lunch with the family on Sunday?
Sunday?
Yes.
Okay. Lunch, that'll be very nice.
That would be great.
Thank you very much. I'm most grateful.
Don't mention.
Thank you.
Jack, all you need right now is a very good rest.
Yes.
May God bless you.
And you too. You'll be fine, okay?
Yes.
All you need now is just to go inside and have your bath. And stay indoors. Don't even come out all through today. Okay?
I'm grateful. Thank you very much.
Mother,
Stanley.
Please take good care of you.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
May God bless you.
And you too.
Thank you.
I'll have to take my leave now.
Okay, son.
Thank you.
So, see you on Sunday then.
Right. I'll make it.
Bye-bye.
You are very, very funny, I'm telling you.
What do you mean by that?
So
I want it to
now. I'm sorry.
Let me call you back.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Oh. Forgive me, I'm sorry.
Oh.
I'm sorry. All right, you go first. All right?
You go first.
Haven't you heard about the word ladies first?
I see. You're a perfect gentleman. You're a rare breed. Thank you. Let me go.
You fool. You let her slip through your fingers. Oh, hell. It is no use. If she knows my condition, she wouldn't have even said hello. My word. Honestly, I'm looking lost for how your beauty stops my heart from beating anytime I set my eyes on you.
So, this is your house?
Oh, Stanley, it's you.
Jack.
How you doing? What's up?
Right.
You're welcome, eh?
Yeah.
Come right in, please. We've all been waiting for you. Come in. What are we waiting?
Look at you. You're looking great.
I can't believe you're here. Please sit
so
down.
Where is mommy and daddy?
She went out. But I think my dad was upstairs. Yeah, she went. She went to pick up one or two things.
She didn't know I was coming.
I don't know why. You're welcome.
All right, man.
It's good to see you.
Yeah.
So, you're the Stanley.
Yes.
This world is a very small place.
Well, I wish it's even smaller so that I can keep running into you every day and everywhere.
Well, I see you two have met.
Yeah, we bumped into each other the other day at the shopping mall.
Well, Stanley, that's my sister Maureen. Maureen, that's Stanley.
It's my pleasure meeting you again.
The pleasure is mine.
I still can't believe you came.
Why not?
You're welcome.
I keep to my promise. And I promise, I fulfill.
I know. It's good to see you.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
So what do I have for you?
Well, don't bother, man. We're one now, right?
Oh, well.
Oh, that's daddy.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, good evening. Yeah. How are you?
All right, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
So, you are the young man that... Anyway, I just want to thank you for helping my son.
Thank you very much, sir.
I hear you met at an interview.
Yes, sir.
Good. How did it go?
Well, I did well, sir, but they said that the result will be out by next week.
I see. So, what did you read?
Accounting, sir.
That's interesting. I can do with an accountant in my company. Just promise me that if your interview is unfavorable, that you'll come back.
Why not, sir? The pleasure is all mine.
But meanwhile, you have to do me a favor. Please, talk to your friend. Make him see reason and realize the benefit to come and join me in my company.
Dad, with all due respect, you don't start with me, Dad. Please, I only went for the interview to realize my potentials by myself. I hate the fact that you've been spoon-feeding me my entire life. And how long would this continue?
Jack, I do respect your point, all right? But you can actually realize your full potential by lifting your father's company's name to a greater height that even your father has not reached. Why would you want to waste your expertise and ideas on someone else's company? Huh? All you need to do is just improve upon your father's fortune.
Well, I see. I just realized that you're all ganging up against me. That's it. You're all ganging up against me.
Oh, come on. There is nothing like ganging up. It's just common sense. You can't work upon your father's old idea.
Oh, come on, Jack. Is this guy talking or what?
Yes, Dad, he's talking. And I think it's time for you to keep quiet before the food gets cold. Let's all get to the dining and have something to eat.
I'm so happy to be in your midst, you know, Jack.
Okay,
you know, seeing you again, it's great.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yes, sir.
people are deeply spiritual people. And coldly calculative.
Otherwise, how do you explain the knowledge behind acupuncture?
You seem to know so much about everything.
Edo, this one was not calculated at impressing you. I was just talking.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
I was just talking.
All right, I want you to impress me.
How?
I don't know. Just say something or do something that will make me go wow.
Wait. You want me to do something that will make you go wow? Huh?
Yes.
Okay. Close your eyes.
I should close my eyes. Why?
Come on. Close your eyes.
Why?
Do as I say.
Come closer. I want you to kiss me. My kiss will make you go wow. To make you go more than wow.
I do not want to go more than wow. Thank you.
Okay, okay. You know what? I can turn this day into night.
Man, you guys can really brag just to impress a girl.
For sure, I can turn this whole place into night. Okay, watch me. Watch me. Watch me. Abracadabra.
Abracadabra. Hopis copis. Oya ekboko. Watch me, watch me, watch me, watch me. Come on, close your eyes. Watch me.
You see? You see? It's dark. I can't see anything.
Rubbish.
Okay, okay, okay. Listen, one last one.
I can make one of these scotch eggs disappear.
Really?
I watch it. Watch it.
You're so pathetic.
Okay, okay. Don't give up, alright? I have one last one.
I am not interested.
Come on! Just one last one. Alright? Alright, give me your watch.
What?
Give me your watch.
I should give you my wristwatch.
Yes. Come on. It's in good working condition.
I know, my father gave it to me when I entered university.
Watch me. Have you seen it?
Wristwatch now!
Hey, come on, Ron. Come down, okay?
Tell this man to give me my wristwatch.
Please give her her wristwatch.
Your watch cannot come back again.
You're joking, aren't you? I want my wristwatch right now. This has gone beyond jokes.
You want your wristwatch?
Yes.
But you want it now.
I want my wristwatch now!
Okay.
Wow! How did you do it?
I told you.
How did you do it?
You don't want to say another word.
You were smashing my wristwatch right now. I thought you smashed it now.
Let's just call it magic.
This is truly magic. Wow. I almost went berserk when you smashed my wristwatch.
I saw them hanging around the mother's neck in a boutique as I was passing. and I felt they would look better on you than on any woman or any female animal species in the world. So there they are. Put them on, they are yours.
Some few hours ago. So how is everybody?
Everybody's fine.
Where is Jack?
He's fine.
He's gone to work.
Work? He works? I've been expecting him in London.
Right, you wish. He now works in Popsi's company. You know Popsi's planning to retire? He's planning on retiring.
He never told me anything about this. I have to call him. Oh dear, my bag is in the car.
Oh, all right, where's my phone?
Yeah. Hey. I'm gonna call him.
How are you, girlfriend? You look good.
Thank you. Okay.
Not me. Oh, Maureen. Hello, Maureen.
Hello. I know you don't have time for me. Just hold on. Hold on.
Hello?
Wait a minute. Is that Vivian?
Of course.
Oh my God. I cannot believe this. Honeyboo, I really do miss you. How are you?
I'm beautiful.
Jeez, I really did miss you, Honeyboo. I miss you.
Oh, I miss you too, baby.
When did you get into the country?
No, like a few hours ago.
You know what? Just sit right there. I'll be with you in 30 minutes.
Why not let me meet you at the office?
Splendid. That'll be lovely. Just calm right down. Jesus Christ. I cannot believe this.
There is no way I'd let your brother see me like this. I need to do something to my hair, my nails. I look like, ugh.
So you left London.
Where? I mean, to Nigeria, hello. To fix yourself up.
Listen,
you know how expensive it is there.
By the way, yeah, how is Steve?
Who?
Steve now? Please. Steve is history. He's a lie. What happened?
Please, my head is filled with fond memories of someone else for me to spoil it with Steve.
But I thought Steve was perfect.
Well, the guy is such an actor that he made me believe he was perfect.
Okay, wait. So, this person that fills you with fond memories, he's not acting. I mean, I'm made to believe all men are the same.
If all men are the same, why do we even bother to stay with them at all?
You have a point, you know. Oh, dear. Mm-hmm. But, you know, there are a few different ones.
Yes, like my brother.
Jack. Mm-hmm.
And him.
Okay, so what's his name?
His name is Stanley. Stan for short.
Ooh, I can tell when a girl is in love.
Please.
Oh dear. Mm-hmm. Anyhow, just go easy, girlfriend. Love with your heart. Think with your head.
Thank you very much.
Where is my box of clothes?
First of all, let me just go to the salon.
I really, really need to get my hair.
Also, you will fashy me.
Maury, come now, please. You know you have to help me do something to myself.
To find out if Stanley lives here.
Yes, he's my son. I hope there's no problem.
No, there's no problem at all. I just want to see him.
Okay, he's in, but not in a very good condition. Can you come back later?
Is he sick?
I cannot say that.
Stanley.
How did you know where to find me?
You're not the only one who is full of surprises. Won't you invite me in?
Oh, of course, come on in. Daddy, come on in.
Right. To know my daughter.
This is Maureen, my new friend.
Good afternoon. To know my daughter, you are welcome.
Thank you, Ma.
And my father, met him outside.
You met.
Good. And this is my younger sister.
Hello.
Good afternoon.
How are you?
Okay. Oh, my dear. How are you?
Where did you get all these pictures from?
He seems to have forgotten that I'm a magician.
How long have they been here?
They've been here for a while now.
What is the meaning of all this?
Maureen, the number of times I see you in my dreams are no longer enough. I also want to see you when I wake up. Every second of the day, so long as I shall live.
So you feel this strongly about me?
Yes, I do. Love sometimes is a weak word to describe how strongly and deeply I feel for you. From the bottom of my heart, I love you.
I love you too, Stanley.
You too. Oh, I love you too, Maureen. I love you so much.
Oh my God, I can't believe. Are you here yet? All right, no worries. Just come right in. I'm in the office. Okay. Okay, okay, okay.
Oh my God, I can't believe it. Oh dear. No, I can't believe it.
I was expecting you back in London. Why didn't you come back?
Dang, you look good.
Mommy was waiting for you.
I had stuff to worry about here, and my dad had to talk me into walking here.
Oh gosh, you look good, baby.
And you too. You look pretty good. Please sit down.
Nice place you got here.
Oh, nice. You call this nice. I'm still working on it, though.
Mori told me about your decision to walk.
It's a nice office. You call this nice?
Well, Maureen told me about this, your new decision to work. I don't know, I thought you didn't want to remain under your famous father's name. I thought you wanted to make a name for yourself.
Yes, I'm still going to make a name for myself here. I intend lifting this company to heights my father never got to. See, I intend spreading the tentacles of this company as far as possible with the people I know in UK and the States. I believe the sky's the limit. What do you think?
Well, whatever you decide, I accept.
Nah. Are you serious?
Sure, I am.
Does this mean you'll be moving in from London to be with me in Nigeria?
Of course!
Oh my God, I can't.
Two people get married, they live together, don't they? There's no way I'm going to be in faraway London when you were here in Nigeria.
Oh my God, I love you, honey, bro. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
It's okay.
I'm so grateful. You know what? What do I offer you?
Champagne.
Nothing. Hennessy.
No, nothing.
Oh my God, you look good. Alright. Oh, Stanley. Nah, come right in. I'm in the office. Yeah, tell him to come in. Yeah. Jeez. I can't believe it.
Stanley, the same Stanley.
Yeah, Stanley. Exactly, the Stanley.
You mean Stanley, like Stanley Warren.
And that's the man I was talking about. That's the man.
I got it.
What? I got a job! I cannot believe this.
I've got a job!
I'm extremely happy.
Listen, you don't need to be happy. You need to rejoice with me.
You know what? Nah, I'm not happy. Seriously, I'm not happy.
What do you mean you're not happy?
I kept praying night and day for the company to turn down your application so you could join me here in my dad's company. How do you expect me to be happy?
Bad belle. Listen, let me tell you, boy, you need to see the offer. I am telling you, I have a house of my own, a private car, and a driver.
Are you serious?
Yes, the company anywhere I have to go, boy.
Oh my God.
Check out this job.
Oh my God, I'm extremely happy for you.
You don't need to
Congratulations, Stanley.
You know, please forgive me. Forgive my manners. I'm extremely sorry. Stanley, that's my fiance, Vivian. She's been in the UK.
No, hold on.
Yeah?
Are you trying to tell me that I'm seeing Vivian?
That's Vivian, no?
For real?
Yeah.
I've heard so much about you.
Maureen has been going like, you know, standard. I mean, she's like all standing.
Can you imagine? She came in 2 hours ago from UK.
And Maureen has already told her a lot about me.
Of course.
Oh, listen, don't mind her, okay? You know, people hide away their bad character.
Oh, I see.
So never mind. I'll tell you the bad ones.
Can you imagine?
She never told me you were funny, you know?
Come on. I'm so happy to see you, all right?
Same here, same here.
Welcome back to Nigeria.
Thank you so much.
She's going to be staying a while this time.
Pleasure is all mine.
That's the person making everything happen, you know, doing over there.
Anyway, I think I have to.
No.
Do you want to leave now?
No, honey, bro, don't do this. Don't do this. No, really.
You know I gotta go shopping, don't you?
Let's leave now. Mm-hmm. You know what? I want you to come by the house today in the evening. Would that be okay?
I'll be fine.
Oh, have a lovely day. All right.
Take care of yourself, Dandy.
Okay, then. Take care.
Drive safely, though.
I will.
Hey, well, you're lucky, man. She's great. Huh? I said she's pretty and you're not happy.
God, why have you done this to me? God, why me?
What is your problem? Talk to me.
She has no idea I'm epileptic. She doesn't know I'm epileptic.
How come? But you've been living together in London for a long time.
I left England after schooling, 1.5 years ago. I was normal, Stanley. I was like every other man on the streets of London. until 9 months back, Stanley. 9 months back, I had a terrible car accident that led to this. Epilepsy.
So,
Stanley, I'm scared. I'm afraid.
Wait, are you trying to tell me that you never had it all this while?
Stanley, I never had it then. That's the problem. I never had it then. I was normal, Stanley. Look at me now. Look at me. I have everything in the womb. Epilepsy, Stanley. I'm so scared. I'm afraid I'll lose her, Stanley. I have everything. My health is messed up, Stanley. I'm not happy.
Listen, okay? Just calm down.
I'm not happy. I'm not happy.
Calm down, be yourself, alright? I know how you feel.
Stanley, you have no idea. Do not tell me you know how I feel. You have no idea how it feels. You have no clue. You don't sit here and tell me you know how it feels. Look at me, Stanley. I have everything in the world I ever wanted. Stanley, look at her. I tell you, people tend to run away from me, Stanley. They run away far as possible. Each time they find out about my condition and you sit here and tell me you know how it feels.
Listen, Jack, I am your friend and I've never run away from you, okay?
Stanley, she's everything. She's everything I have. She's everything I've ever prayed for. I have a house, I have everything. And look at me with epilepsy. How do I put up with this?
Okay, just put yourself together, right? Work something.
Where is your father?
Yeah, he's inside.
Mr. Newspaper.
Mr. Johnson.
Mom?
Oh, son.
Good afternoon, Mom.
Afternoon,
brother.
My dear.
Ah.
Let's go, brother.
How are you?
You're welcome. Hey.
Fine, very, very good. I think you're enjoying yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I have something to take care of.
No. Son, please come.
I want to talk to you. Yeah, Benita, can you please excuse us?
Mom, what is it? I hope there is no problem.
Nothing serious, but very, very important.
So, what could that be?
For a couple of days now, your father and I are overjoyed with the good things, you know, that has been happening with you. And we wish it should continue. You know, like that.
Amen.
But I am worried for you.
Worried? Mom, you just said it yourself now. That you and my father are happy about the good things that's been happening to me. So why worry? That goes to show that the future is bright.
It is Maureen.
Maureen?
Yes.
What about Maureen? Mom, do you really need to worry about Maureen? Come on, Mom. Maureen is a nice girl. She's a nice girl. And if you get closer to her, you will appreciate her more.
Of course she's a good girl. I have seen you suffer terribly of a heartbroken when that girl dumped you in school. You went through school with that pain in you. And you never dated anyone since then up till now. I don't want to see you go through that kind of pain again. Have you told her about your condition?
No. Mama, can you say such a thing? No, wait. You want me to tell Maureen that I'm epileptic? Mom, is that what you're trying to say?
That's exactly what I mean. You are going too deep, son. You should have told her long before now. You should have.
Well, I guess I was carried away by the fortunes of the things that's been happening to me in the past. Mom, for the very first time, I am truly feeling like belonging to this life again. I am truly loving someone, and I want it to last that way.
And life gets better when we don't forget about realities. The reality is your condition. Tell her, son.
Mom, I'm scared. I can't. What if she dumps me?
Stanley, it is better you tell her now, not later.
Mom, telling her now or later makes no difference. It makes no difference. If I tell her now or later, it's still the same thing because she's still gonna leave.
Don't say that, son. No pain is too much for time to heal. Be brave. Do what you are supposed to do. If Maureen truly loves you from her heart, she will not let you down. She will take you for who you are. Tell her, son. Be brave, okay? Tell her.
Thanks, Mom. Yeah. Why do you ask?
Because you're not yourself. You're dull.
I guess I should just cheer up, you know. I like good stories. They make me feel fine.
So, tell me one.
It was the end of a war. And a young soldier called his parents to tell them that he will be coming back home. But he would not be coming back home alone. That he'll be coming back with a soldier friend. And this friend of his lost his one arm and one leg during the process of the war. But the parents didn't like the idea. Him son. I said, son, how do you want to come back with such a person? Why don't you send him back to his parents or relatives or something? He said, no. The parents and relatives, they all died during the war. They lamented. They never liked the idea. They call him son. Why don't you dispose him? Come back home alone. We have our own worries to take care of. And the boy said, okay.
Is that it?
No.
Is that the end of the story?
No. 2 weeks later, somebody called the parents to tell them that their son committed suicide. They never believed him. They told the caller, how possible is that? Their son cannot commit suicide. And the guy said, I'm sure. They said, it's not true. And the caller said, I'm sure. He described the boy to the parents. The name and every other thing was correct. Except the fact that he was disabled. One leg and one arm.
Jesus. So you mean it was their son that had an arm and a leg lost in the war, not a friend?
Exactly.
Why didn't he tell them? Why did he have to lie?
He never wanted to be a burden to anybody, more especially his parents.
That's sad. Very sad.
Yeah. Very sad. Maureen.
Yes?
That I'm about to tell you now is equally sad.
Let's hear it.
I don't know how to tell you this. I'm epileptic.
You're a very mysterious man, Stanley. Very mysterious.
It's not a joke. I'm epileptic. Just like your brother, Jack.
Are you serious?
I'm as serious as death.
You're a very mysterious man, Stanley. Very mysterious.
It's not a joke. I'm epileptic. Just like your brother, Jack.
Are you serious?
I'm as serious as death.
And you never told me.
Stanley, son, please, you must eat. You do not touch food nor water for whole 2 days now. What do you want to do? Starve to death?
No, I'm sorry. I just want to be left alone.
I'm sorry, son. I will not stand by and watch you wring yourself. You've not been to the office for 2 days now. Do you want to lose your job?
Nothing can change that. No circumstance, no condition.
I love you too. I'm so sorry I didn't let you know about my condition from the start. I just wanted you to know about me before my condition overclouds your judgment. Just like it often happens to the people I met in the past. You don't mind my condition. I want to share something.
Really?
Yeah, come with me.
Okay.
Let me get what I want to give to you. I've kept this for many years now, waiting for the right woman. And I want you to have it. Will you marry me?
Yes, I'll marry you.
Then let me help you. You're more beautiful.
Thank you.
I'm glad you like it.
I like it.
I am curious to know, my dear.
I didn't know you were coming.
Maureen,
yes,
I have noticed a marked difference in you since the day before yesterday.
I don't understand.
The last time I heard you sing a song in this house was when you were in love with Harry. So who is it now?
Oh, please don't be ridiculous. You're making me shy.
No, my dear, I am not. I have eyes and I see things. And I have noticed that you have awfully been seeing this boy called Stanley of late.
He has proposed.
What? He has proposed?
Yes.
You devil! You didn't even tell me. He gave this to you?
Yes.
How?
This is good.
So when are we expecting the wedding bells to ring?
I haven't chosen a date yet.
Why? What are you people waiting for?
Very soon. Very soon.
Maureen. Is there anything the matter? Are you having problems with him and the family?
No, no, no.
Then what is it? Tell me. I am your mother.
Mom, Stanley is sick. He's epileptic.
Good gracious. Stanley? Maureen, are you crazy?
No. He's still the one I want to marry. I love him.
God, you children of this generation are always hiding behind that word called love. What do you know that is called love, Maureen? You have to open your eyes before you fall in love.
My eyes are open.
No, 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 my God. They are not. If they are, you will not be planning to get married to Stanley. Are you blind to all the trauma and the sufferings we've been going through with Jack for the past 9 months? You want to remain suffering with Stanley all the rest of your life?
Mommy, he's the one I've chosen. Besides, I'm the one going to be suffering, not you.
And my decision as a good mother is that I will not stand to see you suffering or to bring harm to yourself.
Jack, you just have to get those files ready. Contract, okay?
Well, actually, Dad, I've already done that and they've issued in the check.
I see. Yeah. Well, that's fine. Ah, is that not your mother's voice? I'm hearing.
Probably.
It's okay. So, as you've done that, everything is okay now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I'll send the secretary down to the company tomorrow for the meeting.
Okay. That's fantastic.
So, how's your day, Dad?
It's fine now. It's fine.
Daddy.
Ah. Maureen, what is it? I heard your mother's voice upstairs. I hope no problem.
There's no problem. I just told I'm engaged to Stanley.
Oh, that's a wonderful news.
Splendid.
Oh, why is she not happy? He's a fine young man, well educated and with good job. So, what is the problem?
Because I also told her he's epileptic.
What? Who told you that? Answer me, who told you?
He told me himself.
Jesus Christ, Maureen! And you knew about this all the while and you never told anybody. I'm highly disappointed in you. Maureen, you have to realize the consequences of such relationships.
The only man that makes me happy, and if putting up with his ailment is the only price I have to pay, then I consider it a little price to pay for someone who makes me happy.
Oh my God, my God, my God. Oh.
Oh dear. Stanley. Okay, my angel, come. Sit down. See, Maureen, I want you to be reasonable. Just look at your brother. We are always having constant fear anytime he goes out of the house. If he gets a fit outside this house, what is the guarantee that people will help him? They will all run away. Okay, he could even fall inside a pit or into the water, oh God forbid. Anything could happen. And my dear, you know what that means?
Daddy, that was in the olden days. Nowadays, people know the ailment is not contagious, so they're always willing to help.
Oh yes, but let me say this. We will not allow you to marry him. Is that clear? You will never marry him. Never.
Nonsense, Stanley. I cannot believe this. I'm highly disappointed in you. I do not want to see you anywhere less, Stanley. How ridiculous.
Hey, what's up? How you doing, man? I promise you I'll be at the club tomorrow.
Are you serious?
Hey, don't worry.
Hey. Jack, you know what? I'll call you back. What's hold it right there. I'll call you back, dude.
What is it?
Oh, Stanley, how could you?
How could I what?
Stanley, I trusted you. So you put up all that drama just to use me to get to my sister, right?
What drama?
Stanley, do not mess with my intelligence by playing dumb. Now I want you to listen and listen good. I never want to see you anywhere near my sister, my home, or my office. Do you get that?
Listen, Jack, if there's anything going on between you and I, why don't you just open up and tell me? Why rotten like a bulldog?
Jack, what is it? Why are you harassing Stanley?
Maureen, Stanley is not the right man for you. He's not the right person for you. He's been deceiving you all.
And who are you to tell me what is right and not right for me? Are you me?
Maureen, are you blind to see the fact that he has been deceiving you all this while? How come he never told you he was epileptic from day one? How come?
What do you expect him to do? Tell me, what do you expect him to do? You expect him to walk around the streets telling everybody that he's epileptic? Is that what you want him to do?
Maureen, open your eyes, Maureen. Open your eyes. Stanley is not the right man for you. I want you to be happy. Deep down from my heart, I want you to be happy.
Killing the happiness. I was thinking you'd be more sympathetic since you have something in common with Stanley. You hope to get married, right?
Every man hopes to get married.
And you don't wish him to. Come to think of it, have you told Viv that you share the same condition with Stanley? See, you don't have the guts to, but he did, he told me.
It's not your fault. You have a very beautiful heart.
It's okay. I think you should go home. I need to talk to my brother. I need to talk some sense into him.
It's okay.
I'll see you tomorrow.
It's okay.
I'm really sorry. And you don't wish him to. Come to think of it, have you told Viv that you share the same condition with Stanley?
God, what was Maureen trying to say? I don't think she meant that. But I'm not going to talk to her. Not about my heart. That's the last thing she could hear from me. She's definitely not going to find out my heart. Not from me, not in this life. I'll tell her.
smells so wonderful. Wow. And while I was trying to get over that, boom, it pops out past you.
And what? What was that? Oh my God!
Man, see, I couldn't even get over it. I was so excited. I was like, God, it was so romantic.
Oh, I'm really happy for
you.
Hello,
he's just... Hi, darling.
Supermarket to pick up some stuff for my mom, and all of a sudden, bang, a car hits me from nowhere, and I go into coma for 90 days.
Mama, why don't you tell me this?
That's just the beginning. 19 days out, the doctor walks up to my sick bed. Walks up to my sick bed, right in front of my mom, my dad, and more of them. And it's like, I have a damage in the brain. I don't know how you're going to take this, but the damage, that's a very serious case of epilepsy.
What? Whoa, wait.
Wait.
Today about my condition, and instantly she called off the relationship.
Sorry.
I don't know what to do. I could not sleep.
Okay.
I don't know what to do. I swear I do not know what to do. Where do I go from here? What do I do? You know what? It's all right. It's all right. I don't know what to do. I'm confused, I swear. I tried as best as I could to tell her that it's just a deformation in my brain and not a disease. But she told me she still loves me. But she cannot afford to put up with the disease, for Christ's sake. Maureen, where do I go from here? I love her with all my heart. Wait, the thing is, Stanley is extremely lucky. He's lucky he has you. Maureen, I want you to promise me one thing. I want you to promise me you'll make him a good wife. Because I know Stanley. He's a good man. I'm very sure he'll make you a good husband. And I want you to worry less about Mom and Dad. Worry less about them. I'll do my best to talk them into allowing both of you to get married.
You will?
I promise.
Yes. Thank you.
Maureen, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. I love her with all my heart.
I promise you, alright? It will be alright. I promise you that. Okay?
I don't know what to say. I don't.
Do I get you something to eat?
No, no.
I'm stuffed.
Are you sure?
Totally stuffed.
So, what is this thing you urgently want to see me for?
You know it. Viv, look, you've known Jack for a very long time now. You should be able to see beyond his ailment.
Maureen, I love him too much. I can't bear to see him suffering such a feat. It's so cruel. And besides, I don't think I have the guts to touch him. I'm scared.
Yes, it's scary. But the only way we can overcome our fears is to confront them. You'll get over it just the way my parents and I did.
I don't know, Maureen. I don't know. I have to think about it.
All you have to think about is what you guys have shared over time. The love, the years, the companionship you guys have built. Viv, I suggest you give Jack a call if you don't want him dead. Please.
Sir, you sent for me, sir.
Yeah, have your seat.
Dismiss, sir. On what grounds? My services to this office are impeccable. I've been the best employee for 3 months running now, sir. What are this?
I am the general manager of this company, and I have been entrusted to take any decision I feel to make the company better. And I think the general workforce will be at their own optimum performance. Without you, our very person around.
Sir, I don't believe this. This can't happen to me right now.
You don't have to believe anything. I'm sorry to inform you that you have been relieved from work. Your benefit will be arranged in a week time. Good luck.
Hey, good luck. Sir, there have to be something that you have to do for me, sir. You must help me. I have put it in my best in this office. There must be something for you to do.
You have the next hour.
Say that I'm an adult, a young lady, and I think I have the right to make decisions of my own.
And whoever you end up with will definitely become my son-in-law. So, my dear, I have a say in this case as your father. You must listen to us as your parents. My people used to say that what the elder can see while standing on the ground, a child can never see it even from the top of the tree. In case you don't know, people will try everything to get at my money. And I will say it right here. That is what that boy wants to do. I've made my inquiries about him and his parents. They are poor, my dear. They are poor. Oh, come on. Maureen, why do you disgrace me? Of all the millions of men in this country, he can't be the only one for you. Think, my dear. Think! He can't be the only one. You have to think, my dear. And you, what are you doing here? What are you doing here?
I'm sorry, sir.
Now, vanish from my house before I count up to three. Get out! Out!
I'm sorry.
A time when one gets fed up of everything and one wonders if life is worth living at all. Life has always been unfair to me at every turn. I have come to the conclusion that one can only be truly happy and in peace only when one is dead. And that is my final decision to end it all. I hope that Maureen finds the happiness that has eluded me all my life. Maureen, if I have to choose to come back to this world again, I will always love you.
Enjoying yourself. I'll see you in a minute.
Okay, my dear.
Asamoah.
Jesus, Maureen, where have you been the whole day?
How did you know I was here?
I am sorry, my dear. I had to call him to come and take you home. Because this is really not your burden. Eh? You have to go home, my dear. Go and eat.
Maureen, you got us all worried sick. We even went as far as reporting to the police.
Jack, I can take care of myself. I had to come and find happiness. The happiness Dad and Mom never wished for me to have. Look at him. What if he had died? I probably would have died with him.
Your parents will never wish you anything better than complete happiness. And that's why I'm here to bless you too.
You see, Maureen, I had to talk to Mom and Dad at length. And they were extremely sorry about trying to stop you and Stanley from getting married.
So, how are you, my son?
It's okay.
No, don't worry. You'll be okay. You'll be alright. I'm sorry for my behavior to you. To make amends, you and Jack will have to work in my company. Yes. We are one family now.
Yes, we are.
Today is my happiest day because I'm celebrating the union of my children. Jack will be getting married to Vivian. While you will
be married. Hey!
Can you imagine that? Stanley.
Thank you very much, sir. Okay. Are you okay? Mm-hmm. You'll be alright. It has to be alright. Honestly, I can't thank you enough for all you've done for me.
Even what your dad did to me at the hospital the other day baffles me. Honestly, I never believed it. I'm beginning to gain back my confidence. For real.
See, Stanley, what I did that day and what I'm doing now,
sowing a seed. Because I know sometime in the future, someone will be there for me.
You're right. That's true, man. But all the same, thanks a million times.
Oh, it's okay. Stanley, I must tell you, I see you as a friend, I see you as a brother, and I see you as a good man. You're a very nice person.
I think that as a compliment, alright? But you know, like I earlier said, I have an appointment with your sister by 4:30 p.m. Already, it's 3:30, so you know you don't keep a lady waiting.
I know, it's
okay. I have to run along.
That's alright, but do you mind if I ask you some questions, please?
Question?
Yes.
Shoot.
Well, did your parents ever tell you how you came about having epilepsy?
It's a long story, but I'll give it to you. Mom said it was as a result of a prolonged labor. She labored for 3 days. At the third day, the doctors had to do an operation on her. She was so scared. She refused them on having an operation on her. So they had to bring a machine to force the baby out of her womb. 3 months later, she said, I began to have this terrible heat on my head, which resulted to a fever. And each time, this fever results to a convulsion, from convulsion to epilepsy. So I guess both of us are victims of circumstances.
Terrible. Well, my second question is it true that men like us with epilepsy, when we give birth to kids, when we have kids, they would end up automatically having epilepsy?
Well, you see, Jack, this sickness of a thing is even a mystery to me. But I'll tell you one thing. I've seen men with this epilepsy, yet they have healthy children. Our own case is not even in their own category. Our own is not hereditary. Mine was as a result of childbirth and yours as a result of an accident. So I believe God so much and I know that we'll have healthy children.
Amen.
So stop bothering your head.
Well, the last is, how do you intend to manage your illness now that you're getting married to my sister, Maureen?
If I keep to my doctor's prescriptions, I will manage it. So, any more question, investigator?
Nah, please, please, it's okay. I will beg you for one thing.
What is that?
I want you to get my sister, release her on time so she can come home.
Hey, hold on, is somebody jealous here?
Nah, please.
No, let me enlighten you, okay? She is your sister, fine, but I'm her husband.
I know. All right? I know where the line is.
All the same, I'll release her on time.
All right, you have a nice day. Yeah?
You too, man.
Drive safe,
yeah. Yeah, thanks okay. For being a brother, man.
All right, it's okay.
All love.
Drive safe, dude.
Yeah.
Have a nice day. Yeah, hello, Yemi. Is anybody at the reception? Oh, okay, the manager with the ladies. Yeah, please, send them in.
Yeah, I did this at two girls that you asked me to work for the office of the BRO and you don't want to work in your face.
Oh, I see. You may leave now. Thank you very much. Young ladies, you may have your seat, please. What is your name?
Vina, sir.
Vina. And you?
Sandra
Pina. You're welcome. Pina James.
Sir.
If you were given a job in this company as the public relations officer, and you had to lobby for a contract from another company, and you find out that the person giving you the contract is epileptic, what will be your reaction?
I'll definitely turn down the contract.
Why?
Because I heard that the humans is contagious.
And I don't
want to
get infected.
I see. You're Sandra, right?
Yes, sir.
If you were given a contract, a job in this company, as the public relations officer, and you were to lobby for a contract from another company, and you find out that the person giving you the contract is epileptic, what will be your reaction?
As for me, I wouldn't turn down the offer because I feel such people need to be shown love, and me showing love to such a person and making the person feel cared for, I think he might want to do business with me.
What is your name again?
Sandra Penick, sir.
Sandra Penick. Young lady, you may have a nice day now. I'll get back to you.
Right,
have a nice day. It's been nice talking to you.
Bye bye.
All right.
It's okay.
Yeah, hello, Yemi. Please ask Sandra to stay behind. Yes. Ask her to wait behind. All right. They just left my office.
He got these ideas into his head, but I heard he announced our wedding at the hospital.
Yes.
Please, I have thought about this, Jack, and it won't work. Okay, so let's just forget about it.
You're nasty. I love you from the depth of my heart, and I'm willing to spend the rest of my life with you. For Christ's sake, is it a crime to love?
Oh, please forget about this love story. Let's just forget this. It just will not work. I'm not willing to put my life on the line for you. That's the truth.
And remember back in London.
Back in London, you were not epileptic. I can't do this. This is my life. I can't do it.
Vivian, take one good look at Stanley and Maureen. They'll be getting married in a week.
How is that supposed to be my business? How? Listen, Jack, I don't know what you're doing here. I don't even know how you got in here, but I want you to leave.
Vivian, I love you.
I want you to leave now.
You want me to leave your apartment?
Get out.
And your father and every member of the family?
They're all fine.
There is this file you told me last week we were supposed to send to Goya Oyo. They just called this morning to tell me that I've not been sent in.
Mr. Johnson, I'm not in the mood to discuss with anybody or to discuss business, please. I would love to be left alone.
What is the problem? We are talking about 25 million naira worth of business.
Mr. Johnson Agatha, could you save your breath? With all due respect, sir, I would love to be left alone. Maybe we could talk about this some other time. Maybe okay. We could discuss this some other time.
Okay. Amdi, is there anything the matter? You see, when your father was here, he confided in me. We discussed things together. If there is any problem, you can confide in me. You know I'm older than you. I may be of a great help to you.
Mr. Johnson Agatha, I'm most grateful for your effort and all that, but at this point in time, I would love to be left alone. Maybe we could discuss this some other time, maybe over lunch or something.
You know, there's this wise saying that says that the problem discussed is a problem half solved.
No, it's okay. Maybe some other time. Maybe later in the day. You have a nice day.
Okay.
Hello, Shay. Could you come in? Yeah, please bring the document.
You called, sir?
Yes, I did. You may have your seat, please. Have you ever been in love? For God's sake, speak to me! You know what? Just leave. Be my office.
Leave! I'm sorry, sir.
What in the world is going on? I've been trying Vivian's number for days and it...
Why is all this happening to me? Why is all this happening to me, for Christ's sake? What have I done wrong? Epilepsy! What is this drama? God, what have I done to you? What have I done to deserve this, for Christ's sake? Why? Why will this continue? Nothing seems to be working. Wait, come on again.
Please, can you click to Goya Oyo Limited for me?
Okay, sir.
You see what I'm saying? This boy did not send this thing. What is really wrong with this boy?
Sir, is everything all right?
How can everything be all right? 25 million naira worth of business is what this boy is playing with.
I think there is something wrong somewhere. He called me to his office this morning and while we were talking, he sent me out of his office.
He did?
Yes, sir, he did.
Something is wrong. I just have to see his father. Well, I'm in office.
Yes,
Thanks.
that name again?
Good day, sir.
Good day. How are you?
Fine, sir.
Sit down.
Thank you, sir.
What's your name again?
I'm Miss Joan Adiku.
Jesus Christ. Joan.
Go around town telling people he's an epileptic person.
Of course not. We are not everyone. We are his friends, and Annie is his girlfriend. If he doesn't tell us, then he should tell Annie.
Listen, he can't go around telling everybody, can he?
Okay. Well, epilepsy is contagious.
Now that is a crazy thing to say. It is not, and that's not true.
I was told by a reliable source that it is, and I suggest you send him packing out of your room.
What are you saying? Are you crazy?
No, I am dead serious here.
I can't possibly ask him to get out. He's your friend, he's my best friend, he's our friend. I can't throw him out of the house like that.
Hey, look here. It is either he goes or I go. You had better choose one now. Stanley! Honestly, I am sorry.
It's okay, alright?
Alright.
I hold nothing against you. Really? I've forgiven both of you a long time ago.
Yeah.
Okay?
Right. Really? Alright.
You want me to sign your appointment letter?
I think I should be taking my leave now.
Right. I want you to tell John that my wedding will be coming up in a week's time.
Your wedding? All right.
I want her to be there, and I would also like you to be there.
All right. I'll be there, yes.
You sure you don't want me to sign the appointment letter?
Oh, yes. Friend Adia Basrat for our, you know, Ashwebi and Damask for me and you now. Hey, God, I thank you, Father Lord. But come to think of it, though, Papa Stanley, I can't imagine Stanley spending all that lot of money for just a one-day event.
Stanley, I don't know.
Please, that 1 million you want to spend for this celebration is too much. But for me,
That's our offer now. I will spend the 300,000 naira. Everybody will be fed. Fine. The engagement, the reception, the cake, everything will be fine. That money is too much, my dear son.
Mommy.
Yes.
Why don't you let him be? God has blessed, brother. Let him be. Let him have the kind of wedding he desire. He's not borrowing the money anyway.
Hey, I'm a child of the world. Quiet there. Come on. What do you know about wedding and money? Or money and wedding? On set. Give me the bag before you destroy it for me.
Mom, listen. I want both of you to know that this wedding is the best wedding I can ever have in this life. It is a one-day event, yes. This is for a lifetime. I will never have it again. Alright? So 1 million naira is nothing to compare to my happiness. Alright? Look, it is not this lavish thing that you are planning. What matters most is the happiness in the marriage. Eh? Which I already have one. Yes, but I mean, you have to think about the future. Think about the future, the continuity of the marriage. Not just having a lavish party at the end of the day. You end up money, it's not like that. I mean, I didn't even know you were bringing me to this place. Daddy, listen, I want both of you to look good on that day.
Ah, yes, sir.
I want anybody that turned around and they'll see my parents, they'll know that, yes, these are my parents.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Daddy, just choose anything. Please don't complain. I hate it when you complain.
I have clothes at home. I have clothes.
Hey, don't be no, coming here. Dad, I will come to Ajiyabas.
No, Dad, look at
I collect shoes. Those. Yeah? The what are you talking about?
They are going to Ajiyabas.
Yes, so to go and collect the damask we are going to
Dad, use. Please, the pick list, some everything. Shoes. I want you to change your shoes. Pick some shoes.
Who is the attendant here now? Because I can see 12,000.
Mom, pick anything you want.
Yes, where is the shop attendant?
Go down, you'll see anything you want. Benny, look for anything, pick something.
Okay, look. Let me drop this here. Hey!
Oh! You see, it's not like I'm not happy with it. You see, what I want you to remember, your former employer. Remember your ailment. You know how you lost your job in that circumstance? So that is why I am not comfortable. Look, Stanley, anything could happen again. I don't want you to lose this job. And if your employers find out, I mean...
I don't believe this. This can happen to me right now.
You don't have to believe anything. I'm sorry to inform you that you have been relieved from work. Your benefit will be arranged in a week time. Good luck.
Hey, good luck. Sir, there has to be something that you have to do for me, sir. You must help me. I am putting in my best in this.
It might be a different story. That is what I am worried about.
Dad, there is no problems at all. Okay? You see, this particular place I'm working on right now, my father-in-law knows about it. It's through his connection that I'm working there. So this job is as good as certain. I don't want you to see anything like, you know, trouble coming in future or something. This one is okay. So cheer up and shop. That's why I brought you here.
That's my son. I think I'll do something.
I don't want our in-laws to dress more than we.
Exactly. That's what I want.
Oh my God.
Well, I had to call it because I know that you deserve this job. After talking to you yesterday, I felt bad, so I decided to look at your file and call your number because I know that you deserve this job.
Thank you.
I don't have anything against you, okay? I want you to have that at the back of your mind. All right? So I've forgiven you a long time ago.
Oh, thank you very much.
Okay, what are friends for? We've been friends, at least I remember back in the days in school. You, me, Annie, and Oche, and all that. Okay? I just want you to know that I've forgiven you. Once again, congratulations. Alright, this is your appointment later.
Thank you very much.
It's okay.
You'll be working with the marketing department. It's okay. Congratulations once more.
I really do appreciate your kindness.
You're welcome. It's okay. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Small world. Small world.
If it's about the argument we had last night, tell her I'm really sorry. And I'm willing to make up a thousand phones. Tell her I love her from the depth of my heart, and I want to spend the rest of my future with her. So please, can I go in now to see the love of my life?
Do you think I'm lying to you? I mean, she's not home.
Chelsea, do not do this. Now, why are you relenting from me?
Oh, no, I'm not. No, why? No.
No, I see. It's the epilepsy episode, right?
No.
It's all about the epilepsy thing.
Not at all.
Chelsea, God knows this is not fair. God knows the way you people are treating me is not fair. I tried to explain to Vivian as much as I could about the love I have for her. And now you guys are relenting from me because of the epilepsy episode, right? This is it, right?
Not what
God knows this is not fair.
I'm sorry. I have to go.
Chelsea, let me explain.
Sorry,
Chelsea. Where do I go from here? Where do I go?
Jack, why the sudden call and all that?
There's a problem.
What problem?
Right now, I mean, I'm almost insane.
What do you mean? How do you mean?
Do you know that Vivian is nowhere to be found?
I have searched everywhere. She is nowhere to be found. Vivian? Have you tried calling her?
That's what I've been doing all day. I've been to her apartment twice. And you know what? They told me she just left for London.
Without telling you?
Stanley, right now, I'm this close to killing myself. I'll kill myself.
Come on. You don't have to do that. This life is just a small place. Okay? I know she walked out of your life. But do you know what I've been through in the past? Do you have the slightest idea of how many women who have walked out of my life? Four! I've engaged four women all my life. They all returned back my engagement ring with a catapult. From afar, they never even came close to me to even apologize, to even tell me how much they feel about me. So you don't have to endure it. You don't have to let it weigh you down one bit. Okay? We are in our own world. We live in our world. Nobody believes in us. But I tell you, we are one. Okay? I just want you to put yourself together. Don't let this bring you down. At the right time, the right woman who loves you will come your way. Look at your sister. Huh? Look at your sister. It was a miracle that I found her. So I believe so much in God. There is a woman somewhere who will love you. You are handsome. You're tall. You're intelligent. Come on.
Stanley, I love her and I'm willing to do anything. I'm willing to give my life for her. I love her with all my heart.
Listen, the right woman will come to you at the right time. Okay? Stupid.
Tommy, I tell you, I was this close. I tell you, this close to killing myself.
It's a very big scene to take your life.
Right?
I want you.
it's hard to run along at the call and all that. It's okay.
You know what? To settle this, I'll make out just go to club, have a drink or two. Take my time, maybe I might stumble into something.
It's okay, Mama, just take care of yourself.
Nah, it's gonna be okay.
Don't do anything stupid.
It's gonna be okay.
Alright?
I'll just move on.
Remember, my wedding is just a week's time.
I know.
And I know my way to see this family come.
No, definitely. No, they're coming in. They're all coming in.
It's appointment.
Nah, definitely. They're all coming. All right. Stanley, I'm grateful.
You're my best man, you know.
I'm grateful. Nah? I'm grateful.
Don't go.
You have a nice trip.
Take care of yourself.
Yeah, no worries.
All right.
You know what? Let me just get my thing so I can drop you off in the corner or something.
All right, then. It's okay. Yeah.
All right.
Hello? 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 Kales?
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Pick up the phone.
It's another party, it's another whore. And everywhere I go, it's another homie. It's another drinking, it's another room. And in that cash, it's always a tailor, always a jeweler, always a hater. When you's a star, it's never a way out. These broke ass niggas is gon' have their hands up. I'm tired of the drama, I'm about to hop my ass off.
Contagious, and I don't want to get contacted with epilepsy.
I tell you, it's not contagious.
Says who?
Says me.
What is your problem?
The only thing that is wrong here is that I'm epileptic. And I want to turn the rest of my life to you. I want you to get my life. I don't think I deserve a second of the head.